Hello friends, Mandar here. I'm back with another video. Today is one of those days where a lot of people who are waiting for green card are waiting for this day, which is visa bulletin. So it has finally come in for the month of December 2020. In the last few months, we have been seeing it coming very late, but to our surprise, this month it has come in on 20th of this month, which is a great news. So now we can plan for December 2020. So if you're interested in knowing the changes in the visa bulletin for December 2020, stick around until the end and let's get started. If you are here for the first time, welcome. My name is Mandar and I make immigration related videos for US and Canada. I'm not an immigration lawyer, so anything that I say on this video or on my channel is for information purpose only. For your own personal immigration needs, you should hire a competent immigration attorney. And if you like this video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel. Now let's get started. So every month we get the visa bulletin published for the next month. I have made several videos on what is the visa bulletin, what is the purpose of it, and what information can you get from it. I highly recommend that you check that video out on my channel. So today, finally, we got the visa bulletin for December 2020. Now let's go through it and see what are the progression. I'll make a side-by-side comparison from November visa bulletin to December visa bulletin. And we'll go through family-based charts first, and then we'll look at the employment-based charts. A lot of my subscribers are from employment-based category, so I want to spend as much as time as possible on comparing the dates for the employment-based category. But first, let's start with the family-based. Okay, so now what you can see here is the November 2020 visa bulletin is on the left and December 2020 visa bulletin is on the right. So I'll scroll down to the final action dates chart for family sponsored preference category. So let's do it for both of them. So here it is, side by side comparison for final action dates for family sponsored preference cases. So let's look at all chargeability, China, India, Mexico, and Philippines, because those are the ones that get backlogged quite a bit. So for F1, unmarried sons and daughters of US citizens, you can see the date for all chargeability has not changed at all. The date for China mainland is still the same. For India is also still the same. Mexico is also the same. And Philippines is also the same. Now remember that immigration ban from outside of the United States is still in progress. So that could be contributing to these dates not changing at all. Now F2A is spouses and children of green card holders. That is current across and it remains current all across, which is great news. Now F2B is unmarried sons and daughters of permanent residents, which is green card holder. But as you can see, the dates have not changed at all, which is really frustrating for people in this category. Now F3, married sons and daughters of US citizens. And as you can see, there is no change in the final action dates for F3 as well. The same for F4. So literally there is no movement in final action dates chart for family-based category. Now, as you know, there is an immigration ban and due to which there are no visas or immigrant visas being given for any family-based or employment-based preference categories from outside of the United States. So those things are probably contributing. And also there has been a lot of delays due to the pandemic and due to all other reasons. There are a lot of applications that are still pending and USCIS is incapable of processing them due to various reasons. So family-based category is not moved at all. Now there is some good news on the employment-based category, which I have predicted in my previous video, and that trend continues. So for EB1, if you look at employment-based final action dates for employment-based preference category, for China, it has moved by 4 months from December 8, 2018 to April 2018. For India, it has moved from December 2018 to April 2018. So China and India are going hand in hand. For EB2, China has moved from April 26, 2016 to May 1st of 2016, so just by a week. EB2 India, the date has only moved by a week, which is September 22nd, 2009 to October 1st, 2009. So I really expected that EB2 dates would progress a little bit faster, but it seems like they are not. The only reason I can think about, they still haven't sorted out the applications that are coming in into USCIS for 485. Remember, we have also seen that there is a delay in the receipt notices given out. A lot of people have not still received their receipt notices for 485, which means USCIS still doesn't know how many EB2 and EB3 category applications have they received. So that might be the reason the dates are still not moving forward. EB3, as you can see, it moved from October 1st to November 1st for China 2017, and for India it moved from 1st of March 2010 to 15th of March 2010. Again, this is just a 2 weeks moment, which is really very slow than what we had anticipated. So as you can see, EB1 continues to move forward by leaps and bounds, and I'm predicting that EB1 will keep moving faster and faster until it's current or very close to current in the coming year. But EB2 and EB3, unfortunately, in this month it's only 1 week of progression for EB2 India and 2 weeks of progression for EB3 India, which is really heartbreaking. But I anticipate as USCIS looks at all these flood of applications coming in, as they continue to receive it, send out the receipt notices and start tracking those numbers for EB2 and EB3, we should see these dates being progressed at a faster pace in the coming months. Now let's look at the filing date chart for employment based category. You'll find something interesting that has happened in the filing dates chart. Now here is the filing dates chart for employment based category. You have Now look at the EB1 category. For mainland China, you can see has moved for EB1 from September 2020 to November 2020, and same for India. So for filing date chart, they have actually progressed the chart by 2 months, bringing it current for India, which is incredible. This means that they are anticipating that there are, for EB1, there are enough visa numbers for all the applicants that are filing for 485 for adjustment of status. Even for the final action dates chart for EB1, that will become current sometime this year. So very good news for EB1 category. For EB2, China has remained the same at October 2016, and also India. So India dates for filing date chart have not moved. They are still at 15th May of 2020. But now look at EB3. EB3 has retrogressed. This is incredible. EB3 has retrogressed by one full year. November filing date for EB3 was 1st of January 2015, whereas the filing date chart for EB3 has retrogressed by one full year. They haven't still fully opened up all the applications and responded with the receipt numbers yet, but looks like they are seeing a trend of EB3 applications getting filed much more faster, and thus they have retrogressed the filing date chart for EB3 by one full year, which is incredible. And this is partially also due to the EB2 to EB3 downgrades that are happening. That is probably contributing to this retrogression of filing date chart for EB3. So there you have it. So in summary, what has happened is for family-based category, nothing has changed in the final action date chart, unfortunately. So not a very good news for family-based category for filing date chart. For employment-based, there is a mixed news. For final action date chart, EB1 has progressed significantly and will continue to progress throughout the year and even become current. But for EB2 and EB3, the final action date chart has not progressed by much. And for the final action date chart, EB1 and EB2 remain the same, but EB3 has retrogressed by one full year. So that's in a nutshell what we can see in the December 2020 visa bulletin. I also wanted to tell you if the USCIS will allow us to use the filing dates for the month of December 2020. It looks like they haven't published that information yet. On the website, it still shows coming soon, but I have seen that they publish that in a few hours, if not by tomorrow morning. Once that information comes in, I will be sure to let you all know about this information. So that's all I wanted to say in this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and stay tuned for my upcoming videos. Subscribe to my channel and I'll see you in the next one.